Hi, church. We are the second week of our lockdown now. I really hope and wish that all of you are making the best use of your time. Well, the fact is, since we have able to go through 2 weeks, I'm very sure all of us can make it to the end of the month. You know, as I was meditating this week, the song that keep reverberating in my mind is the song When You Believe, from the musical The Prince of Egypt. One of the best duet I've ever heard singing this song was Mariah Carey and Whitney Houston. But the song that I like best for this season is the one sung by the One Voice Children's Choir. And I'm going to play that for you at the end of this message so that all of us get encouraged by the wonderful lyrics of this song, which is so appropriate for this time and season. Can I just sing one of the portions to you? There can be miracles when you believe. Though hope is frail, it's hard to kill. Who knows what miracles you can achieve when you believe. Somehow you will when you believe. So sorry for the singing, that's the best that I can do, you know. I like the songs that is sung by the children's choir because it is sung by the children. And as I heard that again and again, it is as if the children reminding us, the adults, reminding us, Mom, Dad, keep on believing, because when you believe, I can believe. I'm looking at you, Mom. I'm looking at you, Dad. You have to believe so that when everything is done, everything is settled, and the virus epidemic is killed, is receded no more, when the children grow up, they can tell their own children, you know, in 2020, I looked at Mom, I looked at Dad. They believed. They believed in God, and God worked a miracle. Can I affirm you, my friend? Let's all believe. You know, there's one part of the song that I don't like, which says that when you believe in times of fear, when prayer so often proves in vain. I could not resonate with that part of the song. Why? Because prayer is never, never in vain. Prayer is never in vain. That's why we started the Elpizo ministry. Elpizo. I believe in God. El is God. Pizo is I believe. You know, the same Greek word for belief is pistos, which means faith, hope. Faith, hope, belief. All the same. And that's what God wants us to do. That's why Elpizo is so successful. And we've seen so many cancers healed. Why? Because they believed in God. So can I encourage you, church? This time, this difficult season, don't stop believing, because a miracle is just around the corner. I just want to read to you Hebrews chapter 6 for a meditation this week. Hebrews chapter 6, verse 17 to the end of the chapter. Because God wanted to make the unchanging nature of His purpose very clear to the heirs of what was promised. In other words, to you and to me, we are His heirs of His inheritance. He confirmed it with an oath. God swore. What did God swear? God did this so that by two unchangeable things in which it is impossible for God to lie, we have fled to take hold of the hope offered to us, that we may be greatly encouraged. We have this hope as an anchor for the soul, firm and secure, and it enters the inner sanctuary behind the curtain, where Jesus, who went before us, has entered on our behalf. He has become a high priest forever in the order of Melchizedek. I like this portion of scripture. Why? Because our hope is secure, is safe. And our hope is in nobody else, not in man, not in strategies, not in all the things people do, but in Jesus Christ and Him alone. Why is it that our hope in Jesus is so firm and so secure? Three reasons I give to you. Number one, our hope in Jesus Christ is firm and secure because of what He has done on the cross. He has paid the price for your sin and my sin on the cross and shed His precious blood for you and for me. That's why Romans chapter 8, verse 31 and 32, and you've heard that shared by Pastor Lee Chu in one of the night prayer sessions. What can we say in response to all of this? If God is for us, who can be against us? If He has done all these things and He freely and will graciously give us all things. In other words, what it means is this. If we doubt God, God says, why do you doubt me? I have given you my ultimate, my son for you. Do you still doubt me? If I can give my son for you, can I not freely and graciously give you all things? That's why our hope is secure in Jesus Christ. Also because of this, He is risen. He is alive. He is not still in the tomb. That's why our hope is firm and secure in this as we approach Easter. More so, our hope is in the resurrection power of Jesus Christ. The virus will be killed. The epidemic will recede. But the third thing is simply this. Can I affirm you, my friend? The reason why our hope is so firm and so secure in Jesus Christ, as mentioned in this passage, is because Jesus Himself is now, even as I talk, is now and in the inner sanctuary as our great high priest. So what does the high priest do? Pray, intercede. So even as we pray, Jesus is praying for you and for me. He's interceding on our behalf, my friend. So no fear, only hope. Even as we continue to hope, we want to believe that God will indeed work a miracle. Hallelujah. Let me pray for you. Father, in Jesus' name, I bless every person in listening to this short exhortation. Father, it's not rhetoric. It's not rhetoric. It is fact, Lord. The empty tomb is a fact that Jesus Christ is alive. And because of this, we have a living hope. Thank you, Jesus. So I bless every household today that we will not give up, but keep believing, keep hoping, because a miracle is just around the corner. Thank you, Jesus. We bless you. We give you glory. We give you thanks. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Stay on and just listen to this wonderful song. I would encourage you to have the lyrics before you, even as you hear this song by the One Voice Choir. God bless you.